So it's been an interesting road since breaking my 90-day juice fast. It's been about 2 weeks since eating solid foods, and it was not easy in the beginning. Everything hurt, and I'm just getting constipated, and things still aren't perfect. But we're working through the pains. We gotta rebuild the gut. Don't panic. Every time I get a little discomfort, I jump onto another diet. We're not doing it. This is the path. This is the one. So I show you what I'm eating in a day now. Intermittent fasting, raw vegan. What could go wrong? Nothing.
I am a vegan. You are a loser.
So I'm intermittent fasting, but it's like the sissy version. I aim for roughly a 7-hour eating window. I'm trying to do like 2 fruit meals a day plus a green juice. So far, so good. It's been confusing. I was so used to just drinking 6 liters of juice a day, and now it's like I'm planning all this stuff, how much to eat, and this is good. I make a juice and then eat a bunch of fruit and then go about my day for a while and then eat another meal and you'll see it. So I've already worked out. We're working on the planche. I got a full handstand from like a very basic resting pose to full control all the way up. We got it. And then we do some weird looking handstands. They help for my shoulder just to lean forward a bit more. And I keep my legs on the door now. I'm a sissy fruit boy bitch. That's a fruit boy bitch handstand push-up. And then I'm just practicing a tuck planche hold. I think my goal is 1 minute. And then once I get the minute, I'll try to like extend one leg out and we'll get a full planche one day. Trust me, it's gonna happen. We're up to 39 seconds if you count the pause to start the stopwatch and stop it after. So my green juice today, got celery, cucumber, spinach, lemon, ginger. Fantastic, delicious, savory. Starting the day with nothing sweet, and then it's like, oh, I wish I had something sweet. There's fruit. What a plan. Cheers to you. Tastes like chemtrails and pesticides and anti-nutrients. That's fine. No, it's really good. Sour, salty, ginger, spice. Can't go wrong with that. See you at fruit. Alright, so I waited maybe half an hour. I'm ready to eat my meal now. It's just a cantaloupe. I might have more fruit after this, but usually after one, it's hard to eat anymore. So what I do, scoop out the seeds and then peel the whole thing, chop it, and I'm good to go. Boom shakalaka. So usually one, maybe 2 cantaloupes. I do have a watermelon, so I might eat this. If I'm still hungry, half a watermelon goes right down the gullet. I like to eat with this bamboo spork. Apparently metal touches anything, you get a positive charge and you die immediately. So don't ever use a metal spoon. Silver, copper, wood, bamboo. It has glue in it. I'll go. Hi. I have a closet of mystery now. I'd appreciate if you didn't look at it. I'm gonna have my second meal. It's basically almost immediately after the cantaloupe, but I felt stuffed, couldn't have it. So we're having a bunch of grapes. These were something organic, like candy crushers or something. I've tasted them, they're weird. It's like sweetness and Lysol. So I'm gonna enjoy those. Fruits are so natural. Alright, it's mid-afternoon. We're going out to buy some fruits and veggies. I need to get some more durian in my life. And these little cane sugar, frozen cane sugar juice drinks, those could be fun.
Oh, wow. What's that?
A vegetable. There's a vegetable there. That's cheap. I've been looking for those.
Oh man, remember in Thailand when they weren't that price?
Oh, that hurts.
All right, there's my little grocery haul. 3 packs of durian, a bunch of these little frozen sugarcane juices. I hope they're raw. They could be raw. And a couple packs of spinach. Craving it.
So it's an interesting diet so far. It's not the most exciting. It's not like every time I sit down to a fruit meal, I'm like, oh, thank the heavens. Usually it tastes pretty good, but yeah. The tomatoes, I'm loving those. But it's not like I'm overjoyed to eat. But I feel good, energy-wise. Digestion's weird still. A lot of you were commenting saying the mangoes were low in fiber, and that's why they hurt and they're constipating a bit. Interesting. Interesting thought. So I added the spinach. I'll let you know how that goes, but maybe because I've been afraid of fiber a bit. Obviously doing this juice fast, and so I'm trying to lower it down, but thinking back, when I did the 30-day vegan starch-based, I was trying to go as low fiber as possible, so lots of white rice, then I added in beans and stuff, but like no veggies, everything low fiber, and that was the worst for constipation. So maybe I do need more fiber, more insoluble fiber. So just take it slow.
Alrighty, it's time for dinner. I like eating the one meal and then going out, doing a bunch of stuff, coming back, having the next meal, and then we're done. It's very simple. Just juice followed by a meal, and then do stuff, play in the universe, and then play with cherry tomatoes. These are the best tomatoes I've ever had in my life. They're like from Leamington, Ontario. The tomato capital of the universe. I should move there. It's close to me. Best tomatoes I ever had in my life. Oh man. I had a choice. There was two. This one weighed heavier, but looked less ripe. I'm a moron. I should have went with the ripe ones. Ah. They're so rich. Those are hands down my favorite fruit right now. So I'm just gonna eat all those tomatoes probably. And then I got like 7 mangoes. Constipating mangoes. Love those. Love that. But I have a bag of spinach to push them through my body. Quadruple washed. That means there's no pesticides, right? 4 times washed. So I don't know where I even sit on organic versus conventional, because I've had like amazing conventional cherries. Beautiful, sweet, $1.99 a pound versus $13.99 a pound organic cherries that tasted worse. And then sometimes you'll have organic blueberries that are like, wow, that's so much better than the conventional. So it really depends on your farmer. Obviously organic is best, but there's organic pesticides and organic chemicals, and you never know who's doing what. I'll probably have a tablespoon of that coconut kefir in my fridge after everything. So that's it. I've been like alternating a day on, day off with that stuff. Trying not to have too much fat overburden my gallbladder or something after the fast. So that's what we're doing. It's not the best. I'm not super thrilled, but I feel pretty good. And I want to continue it to see where my treat is, because I haven't seen it around here. I know I didn't go the full distance, but 90 days was all I could take. Even that was pushing it. So we'll see what happens. If I adjust and then the microbiome duplicates and keep you posted. But that's it. I'm gonna eat my dinner. Thank you for watching the episode and thumbing it up. Thumbs down if you are also about to eat tomatoes, but you're going to dip them in pork blood. They're salty enough. The pork blood, it's probably the worst animal's blood to drink. They're dirty. They sneeze on themselves and then lick it and then throw it up. They're gross, but smart somehow. So maybe that's the smart thing to do. Maybe that's why I'm not healed, because I haven't been throwing up on myself. I'll go do that after dinner. Bulimia lives on. I'll leave after you buy a Vegetable Conspiracies t-shirt. Just replace the police. Subscribe more videos on Saturday.